Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Jambulkar. In last video, we have seen one sample program for string, then we have seen string program for addition of two numbers. In that program, we have seen how to generate events, then we have seen Java string program for calculator, then we have seen how to add different components, for example, checkboxes and redo button. So I have created those videos for that, and you will find those videos in my YouTube channel. In this video, we will see how to create multiple frames in our Java string. So in all previous Java videos on Java string, we have created only one frame, but here we will see how to create multiple frames. So I have written one program for that, and I have mentioned in this my blog post. I will provide this link in description box. From there you can take this code. So when we are creating multiple frames, how output will be seen? Look at this. So here multiple frames are created. So first we will run this program, and then we will see that output, and then we will discuss it. So this is the same program which I have provided in my blog post. We will run this. First we will compile it. Okay, program is compiled. Now we will run it. Now look at this. So only that one frame is created, and on that one frame only one component is put, that is a button. This is a button. Now see, when I click on this button, I get another frame. Look at this. This is another frame. So when I click on this button, I got this another frame, and here I have put some label. So any number of components you can put. You can add some text field, you can add labels, and you can put anything on this another frame. So how these components are created and how these multiple frames are created, now we will discuss here. So to create multiple frames, we need to create multiple classes. So for example, see, I have created one class frame1, and there I have extended JFrame, and to handle events I have implemented action listener interface. This action listener interface provides one method, that is the action perform method. And this action perform method, I am creating object of another frame class. So frame2 class I have created. Now look at this. This is a frame2 class, and there again I am extending JFrame class. So see, in frame1 I have created one button. I have registered that button for the event generation by calling add action listener method. So when that button is clicked, implicitly action perform method is called, and here we are creating object of frame2 class. Frame2 class means this. So this constructor will get run when we are creating that particular class. So when object is created, this constructor is called, and here we have written code to show another frame. And in this way, here we have added only two frames. You can add any number of frames in our program. Now see, we'll see some different options how to use this multiple frames. Again, we'll run this program. Okay. So when I click on this new frame, so I get another. So suppose you are creating one application, and there suppose you are writing a program, or you are creating Java string application for the library management. So there multiple buttons can be there, for example issue book, return book. So if I click on issue book button, so I should get a frame. So I will perform some operations here, and after that I am done with it. I will close it. Then I will have another option, that return book. So I will click on that button, again another frame will get open. I will perform the operation, I will close it. Now see how to manage this different option. Now see what I want. When I click on this button, this frame should get deleted, the frame should get terminated, and only one frame should be seen on the desktop. So see here, multiple frames we can see here, two frames are visible. But what I want, when I click on this button, this frame should be automatically deleted or terminated, and only one frame should be there. So if you want that, we need to call one method that is called a dispose. We need to call dispose method. So as soon as we create object of another frame, we need to call dispose method. So what will happen, our first frame will get terminated and only one frame, another frame will be visible. So here previously I commented it, now I remove that comment. So I am saving this. We will close this previous outputs. Okay. And again we will run this. So here I am compiling it. I am running it. Now see. So this is the first frame. What I want, when I click on this new frame button, this frame should get deleted and I should get another frame. Now look at this. So another frame I got, and first frame got deleted. So how it is possible? We need to call one method, that is a dispose. Dispose method we need to call in action perform method of first frame. So first frame from which we are creating another frame. So this first frame will get deleted as we are calling dispose method, and only another frame will be visible. Okay, so again I comment it out. Now we'll see another option. So I close this. Now what I want, if I run this program, see, we got this output. I have removed that, I commented out that dispose method. So I click on new frame, so I got another frame. What I want, now see, if I click on cross button, both frames got deleted or terminated. Again I run it. This is another frame. If I click on cross button of first frame, in previous example where I have clicked cross button of second frame, now I click cross button of first frame. Again both frames got deleted, but I don't want that. Suppose what I want, if I click cross button of this, so this should get terminated, but this frame should be as it is. For example, see, in our application we are providing different options. For example, see, issue book. So if I click on issue book, one frame should come. I will perform some operations over here, and when I am done with this frame, I will click on the cross button. So only this frame should get deleted, but this frame should be as it is. When another option is return book, so again if I click on that frame or button, so I should get another frame. I will perform some operations here, and when I click on cross button, so only that frame should get deleted, this frame should be as it is. And now to make it enable, to make it possible, we need to do one option. So I have closed that option. See, to make it enable, we need to comment out set default close operation, this method, from the first frame. See, this is method is called in a first frame class. Okay, this is a code for the first frame. So I comment it out. Now see, again I compile it and I run it. Now see, I click on new frame, I got another frame. Now see, what I want, so I commented out set default close operation from the first frame. Now see, if I click on cross button, so another frame is as it is. Now what I want, if I click cross button on the another frame, first frame should be as it is. So in that situation, we need to comment out set default close operation method from the second frame. So see, this is set default close operation. That method is called inside this second frame. So I will comment it out. Now again we will run this. So look at this. Now I click cross button of this frame. So see, only that frame is deleted. This frame is as it is. How it was possible? So I commented out this set default close operation from the second frame. So in this way, you can try different options. I have mentioned all those things in my blog. So in my blog, here everything I have mentioned. You can go through it. So you will come to know. So one option that we have seen that is a dispose. And then we are seeing one frame, I click on the cross button. So only that frame should get terminated, but other frame should be visible. So simple logic is, whatever the frame which you think that after clicking on the cross button, that frame should get deleted, terminated, while other frame should be visible. So from that frame class, we need to comment out this set default close operation. So suppose we want that when we click on cross button of first frame, that frame should get terminated, but other frame should be as it is. So I need to comment out this method. And if I want, so if I click cross button of frame 2, so this frame 2 should get terminated, but frame 1 should be as it is. So in that situation, I need to comment out this line, set default close operation from the second frame. So in this way, you can try different options. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you'll get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.